So a 2-minute warm-up here. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobrow, and joining me in the commentary booth, a player who is 7 years internationally representing India and a former national champion of India, Varsha Majumdar. Varsha, talk to us about this player here.
Thank you, Adam. He's such a good player, Liang Jingkun. I mean, he's ranked number 8 in the world at 25 years old. He's definitely one of the upcoming Chinese players who want to break into the top 5. He's been playing professional table tennis for 8 years and has had 4 big wins. So he's very experienced as a Chinese player. He must be having so much of competition to deal with day in and day out. And for him to actually be ranked number 8 in the world is amazing.
Little fun fact about him, he was the reason that you didn't see Fang Zhendong in the finals of the 2019 World Championships. Earlier on, beating Fang Zhendong, moved on, but Quadri Aruna here has shattered every record for the men of Africa recently. You might notice green rubber on the backhand side of his racket, a new rule that has been approved recently, 4 extra colors brought into the game, typically red and black from before, but now green, purple, pink, yellow. These are the colors that are allowed in addition to red and black. You just have to have black on one side so that it's clearly distinct. There should be no confusion about which side of the racket you hit the ball with. You can still twiddle the racket, but there is no rule about shoe color, so Liang Jingkun flossing it like he should. Like he should. Quadri Aruna, I'm going to go 90% forehand. His backhand is strong enough to keep him in, but his forehand is the one that finishes rallies. Loving those shoes. Liang Jingkun looking good from the feet up. And Quadri Aruna as well. I've seen him lose shoes while playing before. I mean, he really just hustles for the ball, has a lot of leg strength. Used to run track in middle school, but gave it up. And just has really changed the game for Africa. He's the king.
Yeah, I mean, who would have ever thought that an African player would be world ranked number 13? This is his highest ranking so far. He's one of the eldest players in the men's draw at 33 years of age, as you mentioned before.
Again, we're talking 16 of the top men in the world. Quadri Aruna from the Olympics to the World Championships last week, playing incredibly well under pressure. And there's that forehand. Now, Nigeria has a rich history of backhand serves. If you look at any of the Nigerian national team, men or women, they serve backhand like that, and it's very subtle and difficult to read what spin is on it with the side spin.
1, 2.
I can't say enough about Quadri Aruna, but beating Timo Boll and Zhuang Jiyuan, 2 players who were in the top 10 at the Olympics back in 2016. He knows how to handle pressure.
And he also got to the quarterfinals of the World Championships last week in Houston. I mean, he lost to Truls Morgaard 2-4. I thought that was an excellent outing for him.
Sure was. The serve sitting up a little bit, and Liang Jingkun right there to take advantage over the table.
Slight mishit on that serve from Aruna, but such quick reflexes from Jiangkun.
3-4.
Now, Quadri Aruna's forehand feels a bit self-taught in many ways. I'd say one of his greatest strengths is that it is different. If you've got a player on the other side who's so well prepared, how do you train? I mean, China has a history of doing this. You're a great player, but you're not going to be one of the top 20. Please play like Waldner. Please play the same game as Timo Boll. Please play like Truls Morgaard. Good luck recreating Quadri Aruna.
Yeah, and yesterday you had mentioned that the Chinese have all the best training facilities. So when they have a player in mind that is going to trouble them, they have practice sessions against similar kind of players all the time. So that when they actually come up against the real players, they're so well prepared.
Now this is a risky shot. Quadri Aruna's developed this a little bit more. His backhand from behind the table with topspin, it's a bit of a risky shot. It's only a step and a half behind the table, but he's more of a flat hitter with that backhand.
Yeah, relies a lot on his
maybe about serve with Liang Jingquan in the umpire, Mark Beckman. Ooh.
7-4.
Now, one thing I want you to pay attention to, I'd say, take note of, is that Quadri Aruna's pockets are in right now. They are tucked in, like most pockets are. Just remember that. A little bit off the top of the net. Liang Jingquan lifting to try to keep the ball out of the net as Quadri has a flatter backhand, less rotation. Tough to rally with.
Yeah, Jingquan is just targeting Aruna's backhand right now.
And he's going to continue to do that until he notices that Quadri's starting to turn, and then he'll go down the line.
Yeah.
It's going to punish him for stepping around. Because if not, this is what the forehand will do. It will just shred through.
He got the service return that he wanted, slightly high, and his forehand topspin winner.
Look at that forehand, like a sharp knife to a warm stick of butter. Quadri Aruna just penetrating. It took two spinny ones, and watch him change up. Oh man, is that a fast shot. Still topspin on it, right on the elbow of Liang Jingquan. Self-defense. And this is what Quadri is gonna have to look to do, to break the handcuffs and get out of the backhand-to-backhand rally however he can.
Yeah, he's gonna want to move to his backhand corner as much as he can, but the problem that could create is that he's gonna leave some forehand open for Jingquan to target.
So Liang Jingquan now with 4 game points. Subtle change on the serve here, a little bit emptier, less rotation from Quadri Aruna to save a game point. And he tries, hits the racket on the table, makes sure his hand is okay. Now normally if someone hits the table here as Liang Jingquan takes game number one, the umpire will ask to see the racket to make sure that the rubber didn't break. If there's too much crack, if the rubber broke basically anything noticeable, a player will have to play the rest of the match with a spare. And you can go through as many rackets as you need. It's happened before, but players want to be careful because they like playing with their main racket and they also like playing with their hand in proper form. So Quadri has no coach in the corner. It wasn't easy to get a lot of people here. Privileged to be here, but side by side, look at these two. 2-0 in their head-to-head. It was 2018, a 4-1 victory. In 2019, 3-0 for Liang Jingquan. Experience-wise, Quadri Aruna is 33 years old. And I mean, look at their career matches. That says a lot, Barsha.
Oh yeah, 263 matches. That's a lot of table tennis. He's been a pro for 14 years and has had 9 wins on the tour. This is his highest ranking of number 13.
So we shall see here. Quadri Aruna again igniting a passion for table tennis throughout Africa like none before. A good setup here. Liang Jingquan showing some power as well. It's funny, he's one of the most explosive players in the game, Liang Jingquan, on both wings. But Quadri Aruna's forehand is just in a class of its own. Oh, back edge. Tying up the score here.
Yeah, great reaction here from Jingquan here, actually to return the ball, and he returned it with a lot of pace, but Aruna just returned it back with interest.
Hey now, it's a reminder, he's got it from time to time. It might not be super dependable, but he's gonna have to take that chance. I've seen it win him matches before, that backhand loop.
1-3.
Again, usually we're talking backhand punch when we're talking about Quadri's backhand. But he has developed a bit over the years. And this is true for most players in general. If they're very forehand dominant, they need to develop a backhand so that they don't require too much footwork. And an omiyage, a gift for Quadri Aruna.
Yeah, the second one this match from Jingquan. Oh.
I was just thinking, if it says anything about how Quadri Aruna receives, it says he's a very tough player to serve to, which is why there's so much pressure on the serve. And this one from inside the table, Quadri Aruna just stealing the opportunity here. Shows push, pulls back, and behind the head, that forehand comes out. Nothing Liang Jingkun could do. Look at the scoreboard, Marcia.
Yeah, that's surprising, but I think Aruna's prepared to play the topspin forehands. Would it be fair to say that he's got one of the best forehands in the game, Adam? Should be, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I was just going to wait for the point to finish, but Quadri Aruna's forehands, his forehand is very unusual. It's definitely one of the most powerful in the game, one of the longest strokes, and it's just tough for people to handle, faster than most. For example, and he uses the backhand spin shot here. Liang Jingkun, I feel like, is just trying to dodge bullets and figure out how he can keep Quadri Aruna off the forehand. Slow spinny inside the table, gets a passive receive. Well now, Quadri Aruna with a solid lead, very encouraging. We saw 3-10 down, a comeback. 1-9 is a long way to go. Quadri in a good position with two serves. The backhand again, a whip-like backhand. I mean, this is a man who is empowered right now, just can't be stopped.
This is the kind of shot you play when you're either too many points up or too many points down. What a shot that was.
Ooh. Oh, spectacular play. I think many people in the arena thought the point was over, and Quadri Aruna never lies down on the job. I mean, we've seen him recover. He took point of the year at the ITTF Star Awards in 2014 versus Zhang Jike. Made international news because even Zhang Jike came to rest. When you play for the Chinese national team, you don't give up. But that's how impressive his footwork is and his undying effort. Score 11-1 in game number two.
I mean, that's unheard of. The Chinese players do not lose games at one and, 2 points. But Liang Jingkun really, it was like he was up against a very, very aggressive Quadri Aruna in this game.
Yeah, not to foreigners. They don't lose to foreigners with that scoreline. Liu Shiwen with an 11-0 victory over Chun Meng at the World Championships 2019. But look at Quadri Aruna's forehands here. Watch his timing, watch his backswing, and watch where he finishes. Sometimes he'll even finish behind the head. But here, all right up to the forehead, just textbook perfect. It's a lot of leg into it, really no holding back. His shoulder strength is outstanding, his arms, his upper body strength, but the legs power it. Again, one of the longest strokes in these backhands. He just looks so free and at ease. So a bit of momentum here for Nigeria's Quadri Aruna. And a tight serve, well-placed, handcuffing Liang Jingkun on that forehand side.
An excellent service return from Jingkun. The slightly quicker return, so the ball was just out, enough for him to play that shot. He knows he's up for a fight now, because after having lost that last game with 111, he's going to have to try and regroup. It's kind of an embarrassment for him to lose it at one.
That said, one, he's already doubled his score from last game. Two, he's got an outstanding coach, one of the best in the world, in his corner. Quadri Aruna doesn't have a coach yet. He was able to turn the score around the way he did between games. I think that has a lot to do with the experience that we saw. The amount of matches Quadri's played, from playing in Portugal to the leagues overseas, Indian League, UTT. But a nice empty serve here. Subtle contact, less rotation on it, and it's overlifted by Liang Jingkun.
He looks to be in good position after the serve as well. He's expecting the return from Jingkun to be the aggressive one, and he's prepared to play that forehand topspin. And in spite of being so stocky, don't be deceived by his movement. He really moves well, moves to his extreme backhand as well. And Jingkun getting a little bit frustrated, seeing the amount of returns coming back at him.
So Down by 1 second serve, Da Pan. This is well placed, deep to the backhand corner, change of pace, Liang Jingquan. This isn't so common. I feel like Ma Long did a lot of things that others couldn't from the Chinese national team. But slowing it down to spin, clever play. And I feel like he's setting himself up well, Liang Jingquan, with the placement in the early part of the rally.
He's still continuously playing to Quadri Aruna's backhand.
Yeah, please.
He's waiting for the time when Aruna moves, and then he's going to expose his forehand side.
Soft lip at the top spin. Liang Jingquan knows exactly what to do near the table. You can see that deep breath, a sigh of relief from Liang Jingquan. Clever play in the touch to leave it short to the forehand.
That's when he caught him on the extreme forehand on the service return.
Quadri following the ball right there in case it comes down into play.
He did well to hold his ground there on the counter-attacking shots, and it was Jingquan 6-5 up and 6-all now. So another aggressive service return from Aruna.
Can you tell us a little bit about that long push and when a good time is to use it?
I think on the service return, when that was a shot which Jingquan had to reach for, and he was out of position. With so much of underspin on the ball, it's not easy to play the forehand topspin, especially for a winner.
And that's interesting to me. You can see the tactics here as Liang Jingquan tries to pin Quadri Aruna in the middle on the backhand corner. Hit him right on that elbow. He does so twice. And even that third ball, I mean, all three of those shots are there. But I would expect Quadri Aruna to make that third shot probably 4 out of 5 times if he takes it. Perfect length here as Liang Jingquan shuts down the attack, keeps Quadri Aruna off the aggressive in this rally.
A couple of times now he's played the short return, and Aruna has not been able to play the forehand topspin. He's had a change of mind at the very last second.
Good effort here from Aruna, but tested on the wide forehand. Liang Jingquan changing it up, taking his chances by going to the wide forehand, but very specific when he decides to go for it.
Yeah, he's not playing to that forehand too often, but when he does, it's an aggressive shot, and he's most of the times winning the point. Oh!
Quadri gets the upper body out of the way to make room for that forehand swing here. Quite a turnaround from an 11-1 victory for Quadri Aruna. Good tactical changes out here. Liang Jingquan very well prepared and focused to shut down Quadri Aruna.
The backhand shots in that previous rally just got quicker and quicker. And he anticipated that the ball was continuously coming to his backhand. And that's when he played the forehand topspin. He's trailing by just one, and with one serve to come, every chance he could even this. A little bit of home.
practice of breathing and energy. Why am I forgetting the term? Well, now, Quadri Aruna quick in this point, back from his opponent's timeout, back to the towel break that he set up so well with that towel box.
And a quicker serve from Aruna this time, and Jingkun tried to play the aggressive shot. Just missing long, but now he's got two serves to come.
Oh, it is as fast as can be. Can somebody get a radar on that? That shot was ridiculously fast. Look at this. In replay, it looks like it's sped up, but that's just real-time replay.
And the last shot just moved away from Jingkun's forehand, bringing up a game point for Quadri Aruna. Just missing the forehand. That's his favorite shot. He tried to go for it, which was the correct play.
Yeah, good opportunity, good look. Can't regret not taking the shot, that's for sure. Feng Shui was the term I was looking for. As in wind and water. Oh my goodness, what a recovery. Liang Jingkun under pressure. You could feel the difference in the pace. Quadri gets the big shots in this rally. Take another look over the table, recovers the net. Big forehand, arm behind the head. And Liang Jingkun finds the deepest corner on the table, covers the middle. Look at how he has to dodge and maneuver the upper body to make room for that shot. Thank you, quads. Game point, Liang Jingkun. Outstanding play. I mean, this one, it just feels like a miracle for both sides. The rally continues when it looks like it would have been ended by about four shots in a row.
Yeah, the last two rallies have been the best in the match so far. Both players just unleashing their shots. I mean, Quadri Aruna, 4-5 consecutive forehand topspins he's played.
Oh, this shot is good. Catches the edge of the table. I was wondering if we'd see any conversation about it. Some risky play. Quadri Aruna and Liang Jingkun saying, you sure that wasn't the side? Fair enough. Liang Jingkun had been on the other side of this versus Kenta Matsudaira years ago. But fair enough to check. Definitely a close call. Game point, Quadri Aruna. What were you thinking, Varsha?
I'm thinking yesterday the conversation we had about Hawkeye being introduced into table tennis.
Yes.
This is probably the time that it could have been used.
That looks good to me.
Yeah, it looks good.
For me, there's not much question. That's not the perfect camera angle to tell, but still, I think I've seen enough to know that that was good.
Yeah.
So out of the fourth towel break here, Quadri tied up third deuce. Well, now game point, Quadri Aruna. 2-1 lead would be nice. And a timeout now, Quadri Aruna's side. Interesting, interesting.
He doesn't have anyone to speak to, but he's a game point up. And this is his third game point. I mean, he has to take advantage of this one. It's in these close matches against top players that you have to take advantage of the few chances that you get.
Now, in all fairness, the last time he had no one in the corner to talk to, he was beaten in game one, had nobody to talk to, just himself, his experience and his thoughts, and came back and won 11-1. But every time you call a timeout, you're also giving the opponent a timeout. And it's an opponent with a world-class coach. Although, it was the same between games one and two. So, Quadri Aruna, at this point, you've got to trust that he is playing very wisely and really wants to capitalize, seize this moment, because well, you might not only get one shot, but this might be it.
He's playing a fantastic match so far. I mean, he's just able to counterattack all the shots that Jingkun is throwing at him. He's keeping pace with the world number 8.
So serve with Liang Jingkun. Game point, Quadri Aruna. The backhand! The backhand! Out of nowhere, a sling shot backhand, rocks it, and fires through. Who would have thought that the game would end that way? On the timeout, a man who thinks for himself for 1 minute comes back and says, you know what is the weakest part of your game? Your backhand. You know what you should use here to win it? The best backhand we've seen this match. He's already pulled out about three backhands that are pretty mind-blowing. But under pressure, one block, and this one, just a little time, the topspin is on it, and surprise, surprise, Quatre Aruna breaks on through to the other side. 2-1 lead in a best of five, but it's not over yet. Impressive play, Varsha.
Oh yes, very, very impressive. We all were talking about his forehand topspins, but he's won 3-4 shots on his backhand. I don't think Jingkun was expecting that shot to be played with so much of pace. And he's going to have to rethink his strategy. He's down by 1-2. He's going to have to come out very strongly.
Now look at Liang Jingkun's footwork, how hard he's working. We talked about balance, but the feet rarely come to rest. Again, quads for days, abs for weeks. Look at that cover of the middle. The legs, the shorts are crying for air. You can see him stretched right now. I think him and Fan Zhendong both, I can't believe that the shorts hang on for dear life and don't come apart. So down 1-2, Liang Jingkun with the serves on his side. Oh, punishment! Quatre Aruna just punishing that serve. Not a lot of room here inside the table when he contacts it. Go to your room. And this is just a reaction. Quatre Aruna gets the racket up a little bit off the edge. You can hear the sound of the contact, but nice change of pace, more passive block. Still keeps it low.
He actually played an attacking shot after Jingkun had played one of his own.
2-1.
Interesting. Earlier in the day, they called a let when the music hadn't stopped through a point. This time, it actually played through the entire point. It's tricky. I think it's a new thing to be bringing in music so often, but to be able to see exactly when the point is starting and stopping is going to be crucial to make sure the music doesn't play through. Oh, what a counter. Backs off the table. A fadeaway forehand from Quatre.
I think this is the second time that he's played an aggressive shot after Jingkun has played one. The down-the-line shot from Jingkun and Aruna's completely, I think he's clued in. He's playing very, very aggressive. And suddenly, Jingkun is finding that he's having trouble. He feels that he's actually now in a position where he may lose this match. And this would actually be the upset of the tournament, I feel. Of course, we saw the first match, Do Hoi Kim defeating the world champion. But this would be equally as big.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely one of the biggest. And it's not, I think right now we need to just take a moment to appreciate what the score is. Because no matter what happens in this match, this is a very interesting score line. Quatre Aruna up 5-1, 2-1. And this is the more traditional Quatre backhand, the punch. Less rotation, which means flatter shot, a little bit higher risk. Nice soft flip here, inside out, that bit of side spin on it.
Didn't go for the full-blooded forehand topspin, just placed it well to the center of the table, taking away some speed on the ball, but side spin on it.
Two serving six. When he grunts, it's rare that you hear Quatre grunt. And every shot that he plays with his forehand is like most people's grunting shots, except stronger. So if he grunts, you know you're in trouble.
He was at full stretch to play that forehand topspin.
I think this is another moment to look at the scoreboard and the body language of Liang Jingkun as he puts his hand in his hair, and licks the lips. You've got to be imagining the lectures that would come to him after this match if he doesn't come back.
Yeah. I think suddenly he's found himself in this difficult spot. And, yellow card given to?
I'm assuming Liang Jingkun for taking too much time, but we'll see.
Yeah.
He's had his left thigh strapped as well, Jingkun. So maybe that's giving him a little bit of trouble, and he's not able to, take off from that foot. Oh, what a winner. Down the line, holding nothing back on that shot.
Quadri's fired up right now. We saw it between points. Taking the risk here, and it pays off. And the pocket, that left pocket is out. Haven't seen the right. This is just what happens when Quadri really starts turning it on. The pockets can't take it. They need some fresh air. This is very clever play. I think Quadri plays wisely in this point. Changes the pace, plays soft, and when he takes the opening, he doesn't hesitate. Tries for the short side. Has to take that chance. Four serving nine. There it is, the punch down the line. Six match points for Africa, and more specifically, Nigeria's Quadri Aruna. Classic Quadri right there.
Yeah, how did he play that backhand punch? I think there was a different kind of spin on the ball. Six match points.
Good pressure here. Very explosive loose backhand from Liang Jingkun. Saves one match point, but still five to go for Quadri Aruna. There he does it! Quadri Aruna has taken out Liang Jingkun. Can he believe it? Shirt over the face, the green racket is out, and Quadri Aruna has moved on to a very tough opponent, the player who stopped world number one and world champion in 2019, but he could not stop Quadri Aruna. What a crazy performance out here from a man who did it by himself through his career. Of course he had a team with him, but with no one in the corner, Quadri Aruna has moved on to the quarterfinals through a very strong opponent.
I think there's just disbelief in the Chinese corner right now. This is an unbelievable comeback from him. After losing the first game 7-11, he then wins the second 11-1, wins the third over extra points, 14-12, and then 11-5, such a convincing win in the fourth. We thought that Jingkun would kind of, pull up his socks after being 1-2 down. I think it's more disbelief than anything else that he could actually lose to the African player.